Welcome back. A few weeks ago, Blake and I visited a new downtown Springfield business called Heirloom Candle Bar.
And that's right. We had such a good experience with Rose and her team over there, so take a look at this. We are in downtown Springfield, hanging out over at Heirloom Candle Bar with owner Rose Cochran. Rose, thanks for having us out. How are you?
Yeah, thanks for coming out. I'm great. I'm excited to finally have you guys in. We've been open not long. Thank you.
How long have you been open?
A month?
At this location.
Yeah, it's been about a month, so lots happened.
Yes, so tell us a little bit about your business for those that may be unfamiliar.
Yeah, so it's a pour your own candle bar. Really, we just want to invite people in to pick out their vessel. We're trying to source fun, different, unique vessels all the time. And we just want people to pick start to finish, get their vessel, pick out their scents, come up with all their fun combinations, really just make a candle from start to finish and enjoy the experience. I think Springfield needs fun activities, so that's what we're doing.
So this would be perfect then to bring friends or like a date night. Is that kind of what it's for?
Yeah, that's the main thing that we see. We have a lot of large groups, a lot of date nights, a lot of even moms with kids, because it's a simple activity.
Sure.
We've got instructions and then staff that are happy to help with everything. So
what kind of wax do you use?
A soy coconut blend.
Okay. So that's real helpful, right?
It's a lot better than kind of the Target Walmart candles you're gonna see, the paraffin waxes. Soy wax burns long, but coconut wax has a good scent throw. Mm. So it allows for a really strong candle, so you kind of get more bang for your buck. So we did that blend intentionally for all those different reasons.
Yeah, I love that. All right, so tell me this. How did this business idea start for you?
So I, you know, candles really aren't like my big thing. I'm not known for being a candle lover, but I love Springfield. Mm-hmm. And I love business. I love small business. This is the second one. My husband and I right now own three, maybe some more down the road. I just want to continue to build into what Springfield's got going on. Springfield is so friendly to small businesses. And the people here, I think, are hungry for things to do, unique things. They want to be proud of their area. So I want to help build on that.
Yeah. Okay, now I am a candle lover, so we're hoping we get to do this today.
Yes, you guys will get to pick out your vessel, pour your candle, do the whole shebang, and see how simple it is, but people are always welcome to take as long as they want.
All right, Rose, well, let's start this process.
Yeah, let's do it.
Ooh.
Cardamom.
That's a mint, but it smells really good. Like, it's not strong. That smells good.
Yeah.
So the cedarwood's pretty subtle.
Yeah.
So I think you could do something that's a little stronger, but we might do a little less of it.
Okay.
Fallen leaves is a very fall-y scent, so if you love that.
What colors are gonna go with your apartment?
I know, I was just thinking, I'm like, what's like more neutrally?
Okay, white's gonna definitely go with my house.
Okay, I think I got it.
So for these, I would recommend two or three wicks. These are typically a three-wick candle.
Okay.
So you want to kind of get those all equally spaced out in there.
Okay.
These sticky tabs will go on the bottom of each pre-tabbed wick.
Okay.
And you want to press it down really firmly. If you're having a hard time kind of getting your hand in there, then you can use this, the ball end of the stir stick to really push it down.
Okay.
You're kind of going to eyeball it. Those were 18-ounce candles, so I would go maybe up to this amount, and then any that's left, we'll just pour it back in here.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's probably good.
So you guys are not going to pour the scent into the metal beaker.
Okay.
You're going to pour both of them into the vessel at the same time. So you want to use up all of this. You don't necessarily need to use up everything
in
there.
And how full do we make it?
I would leave like a half-inch gap at the top. So you'll just pour in at the same time and kind of keep an eye to make sure you use up all your scent before it's full. There you go.
Okay.
Those are too far apart.
Okay.
So I'll take maybe this one out and put it on that next one?
Yeah, just one of them.
I got it. Hey, there you go. So I assume this is not ready to take home.
No, yeah, so the wax is almost 200 degrees right now, okay. So it's gonna take a while to cool and really set. And we're also gonna clean up the candle, kind of reheat the top, trim your wicks, get it all perfect for you. So it's usually ready next day.
And remind people where you're located here downtown.
Yeah, so we're on the corner of Walnut and Campbell at 400 West Walnut Street.
Okay, easy enough. And then also, people want more information, where can they find that online?
Yeah, we have our website, heirloomcandlebar.com, and then we're on Instagram and Facebook, and we try to keep those updated all the time with things that are going on in the shop, behind the scenes stuff. You don't have to make a reservation,
That's
but you can always
ask.
Call.
Yeah, I was gonna ask that too.
Yeah, if you have a bigger party, is it smart though to call ahead?
Definitely, especially if it's a weekend. Weekdays are a lot more chill, but weekends get pretty packed, so you can always call ahead, or you can make a reservation right on our website.
And what were your hours?
Wednesday through Saturday, 12 to 8, and Sunday, 2 to 8. We're closed Monday and Tuesday.
This has been a lot of fun.
Yes. Rose, yes. Thank you so much for having us.
This was so much fun.
Yeah. I can't wait to see our finished products and light them up in my own house. So.
Yes, you're gonna love it. You're gonna love it.
Thanks.
But, and we've got to pick them up the very next day.
Yes.
And I'm in love with my spell. I did toasted coconut and pink sugar.
And what'd you call it?
Pink coconut.
Pink coconut. That's fun.
Very creative. Yeah. Here's like my little form I put on it, which we'll take this off. It's just taped on there.
Yeah, they just put on there whenever you pick it up. I did cedarwood and amber plum is what it's called. And I called it household's peace, which is so cheesy, but I don't know, whatever. Just came what I came up with. So
it smells like a guy, but like a good guy smell.
Yeah, yeah, for sure. And that's what's amazing. I don't know if you guys could tell in the video, but there is so many options.
There were, and you can like mix and match.
Yes,
kinda. So you
absolutely.
Don't have to pick like one smell like we didn't. Yeah. You know, we put
well,
two things in.
Well, and funny
there.
Enough, we picked the same vessel, is what she
we
called it.
The
but
same,
there's a lot
but,
of good
like,
options,
really,
ceramic and glass.
I picked it, and then you copied it.
Probably, but, yeah. We both just wanted a neutral for our places, so yeah. You know, that's all.
I love them.
All right, well, stay with us.
I was excited. We'll be right back.